This is the full build for the Real Grade RX-78-2 Gundam. Now that I've got all the panel lining done and cleaned up, and all the pieces off the runners and the nubs removed, and the color correcting painting done instead of using the stickers, it's now time to do the build. Now the only sticker that I'm going to use from this, because I do have water slides that replace everything else, and I did the color correcting painting for these metallic ones, the gold and the copper. So the only one I'm really going to wind up using is this for the eyes and you know, the mask essentially area. I'm just probably going to use this single piece as opposed to this with the gold on it. It's just going to be easier to use that one piece. So I do have some tools over here just in case maybe I might have missed, I've got a few tools just in case I missed any nubs or anything like that. But overall, I'm pretty sure that I got everything. But this way I don't have to waste any time getting stuff out in case I did miss anything. So I'm just going to get right into it. Now one thing, because this is a real grade, there is a actual true inner frame structure that's apart from everything else. So that'll be incorporated in. And I did notice there's a slightly different order. This might be depending upon the kit as well. It's starting with the legs and then it moves up, as opposed to starting with things like, you know, the chest and the head and the arms and stuff. So I don't know if that's typical for all real grades or not, but I know with this one it is. So it's going to maybe look a little bit backwards if you've seen my other builds. So let's go right on ahead here. Now, this being a real grade, also, like I said, there's these inner frame pieces, and the inner frame pieces are pretty cool in that they're molded with a couple different types of plastic. So the actual joints are actually part of the molding process. I didn't have to put anything on this together. So if you can see, that moves, and that came all as one piece. And there's another movement here at the toe. So this is the foot piece. And it's just really pretty cool that they're able to do that. And like I said, it's because they use two different types of plastic. One is ABS and the other one is polypropylene, I believe. It's a PP. So since they melt and solidify at different temperatures, that's how they can do that. Now, one thing, if you do decide you want to build this kit, there are a lot of little tiny detail pieces. So you just gotta make sure you've got everything that you need. And I'm sure that there's gonna, I have fairly good sized hands, so I'm pretty certain that there's gonna be cases where there's gonna be little tiny pieces I'm trying to put together. So just be patient with me. So let's see here. Since there is a true inner frame structure, it's essentially going to be a lot of things attaching to the inner frame throughout the entire build process here. I twist that up. You just got to pay attention to the instructions a bit closer, because it's going to tell you when you need to move things around and stuff like that as well. So okay. That's okay. That's cool. There's the thrusters. Okay, that's cool. I'm assuming this is going to have a whole bunch of new ways things have to go together and fit. Because there are, like I said, there are a lot of pieces to this. More than you would get from any other 144 scale. Cool. Okay, I like that. This goes up on top there. Oh, that's not the one. Top of the white piece. And everything fits in nicely. Now, you know, because there's so many pieces, you get these details like you've got two different color right here. You've got a light gray and a white, and it integrates in there. So you're going to get a lot of detail. You got to get that up there. So you got a bunch of, so it's going to be worth everything once it's all together. Including the extra time that was needed to clean up everything and such. And you do need to just pay attention to their instructions as far as manipulating the inner frame pieces. Okay, so this is the back here. Okay, that stays there. And then this other piece is what holds everything together. That is this. And I see. Something I was supposed to take out from. I see. This is another thing I'm not used to. When taking the pieces off the runners, I noticed that there were several places where I had to take pieces off of one area because they're going to be used in others. So they were all molded together, but I had to separate them. And this is another case in that the reason why there's no holes there is that they have this piece that's protecting the holes, it appears. I just have to get the leverage to get that out. There we go. And these are softer plastics, so they hold on a bit better than the harder polystyrene, but just a little bit of patience, you'll get it. It is a bit awkward though. There we go. I'll just put this right over here because I'm not sure if that's used elsewhere. But now I've got where this can actually stick on, which is good. that's the heel right there. Make sure it snaps all the way in. This is going to be super loose. Okay. There we go. Okay, much better. Just had to push down on that part a little bit to get everything to snap in together because it's three pieces coming together in one area. Okay. That's neat. Now this here is the first iteration of the inner frame that they did. I believe they're up to 17 now, and there's been something like 38 kits in the Real Gray, just the standard line. So I don't think all of the 17 inner frame versions have actually made it into kits. They might have been prototypes where they were just testing new stuff and decided, no, we're not going to do that. Because, like I said, I do not believe that they've all been used in production. But they did keep the numbering, it appears, for their attempts. So this is down. This. This right here. That's pretty neat. Easier for me to get off there, so put these on first. I don't know, maybe I'll lift another one. Oh wait, these might be the small ones. There's little slots that these things fit into. I wonder if maybe I trimmed the dark piece a little bit more than I should have, so maybe there was another like little tab that held everything together. If that's okay, if it's the case, then I'll just wind up gluing it on. These aren't moving pieces. That might be what's going on. We'll see. I have a problem then. I'll just apply a little bit of glue to one that's too loose. That's the shin. That's the, it's the ankle guard there. An interesting movement there for the foot. Okay, that's one foot. And we'll go right into the right leg. So I okay, so that needs to be, this needs to turn. Needs to turn so that that is there. Okay. This thing, this becomes the top. This goes here. And this looks like this is supposed to clip. Yep. There. Okay. This piece right here. And then this one. I bet that neutral. too much sense. Oh, really? Oh, come on. There we go. Okay. Alrighty, that. That's like that now. No. This, I'm not spinning this. I probably didn't spin that. Which way is that supposed to go? Okay, yeah, I didn't spin this bottom part. I just spun that. Okay. Maybe that's just to keep it tight until it's put together. Piece in here, okay. Let's see here, okay, so like this, and we have these two pieces. And this would go on like this. This right here. So that slides into that. That's pretty cool. That looks really nice. Nice little color separation there with the little piece sitting in there. Okay, I won't do that as much. I just think I'm just really impressed on how this thing is getting together since it's my first one. Soon this is supposed to go over that. Let that bend slightly. Okay. There are some seam lines. Now, I think this is still technically part of the inner frame, so those may not show as much. It's bizarre that this knee isn't bending yet, but I guess we'll see, huh? Little piece just to finish. Like I missed. Okay, so it is. This is what it's supposed to do, huh? Okay. This. And this little tiny piece here. Ever slightest. That's a problem with these small pieces. Nub marks make a big, big difference. Just a little bit of nub mark. Of course, it doesn't help that there's such tiny pieces that it's difficult for me to hold on to do the cleaning. Also. Okay. Let's see now. And there we go. Yep, that was it. Okay, that's on. And this goes here on the back here. Seam on there. Not what I would expect from a RG kit, but like, it, you know, this is the very first RG kit they ever did, so gotta cut them some slack. These little guys to here. Here's the front. Definitely have to do something with these same ones. We'll see. Oh, I see. There's your fact piece. I can't glue those because they're supposed to separate. Okay. This right here goes into this one because it's the narrower one. And this goes into that. Since that panel line is down, this one will be down too. Yes, that fits in nicely. Okay. And then we have covers here. Fit right onto there for calves. Okay. Look at that. Okay, that slides apart. And then that has an effect. There's more. Oh, there's more pieces to go on. Okay. Here we go. Oh, wait. I forgot about this, didn't I? Sits right on there. So you can only snap in there, does it? Okay. Well, I guess that's supposed to hold it in. Okay. So got this. And this goes on like that. And a little tiny. This little bit goes into here. Oh no, it goes on to here. There. Okay. Those go together. And this goes on here. Okay. Okay. And then this, let's see here. That slides that, and that moves that up. Okay. Okay. Interesting. Okay. That's cool. And then this would go this. All right. Leg one completed. Okay. Now on to leg two. Now that we've done the first one, it should be very similar. Let's get this. Let's separate this. There for right now. This eventually would get turned like that. Okay. Back to the foot assembly. The thruster pack here. Top of foot. Right here. There's the foot, and then we got the other leg in a frame here. So this comes like this, and then it walks into here. This. So it's like this. This tag is facing the back. That's a little bit that way. We've got this. This one. This. Okay.
this back in. Okay, is it done here? Now let's see if I can clean this one up better. Pieces on here. This little piece is here. That's the red one.
Once you get that piece oriented right, then it slides right in. So if it don't fit, it's the wrong way around. And this just pops right onto there. And we've got the next leg, and it's got our separation bits. Look at that. Very nice. Pop foot on there, and we've got leg. We've got a right and left leg now. Okay. Let's do waist. Okay. Alrighty. Now this one, the inner frame piece, came in one piece and you had to separate it once you separated it, once you got it off the runner. So it came with this piece that eventually will fit. This is the side skirt piece. And then there's like this main kind of waist piece. So yeah, this top piece actually is the torso. Is this that way? Yes, exactly. Okay, cool. So that's going to be that way. That will eventually play into it. So we need to get our skirtings done first. So, we'll do this. Take one of these and snap that at the top. These. Okay. There are four of these, so there's going to be front and back skirts. And they're either oriented on the left side or the right side. So just make sure you're getting the right pieces, because the thick part, you know, the top piece has the kind of the narrow part and the flaring out part. So you want to make sure that's on the correct side. And then the same thing with the bottom piece. You want the kind of the trapezoid going towards the nub here. No, not the nub, but the ball joint. And it looks like, as far as the yellow pieces, this little black spot is always oriented vertically in the upper corner. whichever side that happens to work out to be. Okay, those are those. These pieces separated. And we've got to put the chest B together. Actually, this would be the waist B. This is the waist B. Once again, some hook. This we need to get glued on the pending. This all sticks inside a frame, so once I get it in there, it should stay together, but very nice color separation with just the pieces there. Where this fits into. Nub on there, so I'm gonna get rid of that. That might have been stopping it from going. Yeah. These tiny pieces are gonna be where the catch points are if I didn't clean them close enough. That's something I'll note for the next real grade, that I've got to be real, real thorough with the cleaning phase. Okay. Just come on. Have to put this down and work on something else soon. Yep. Let's see here. Okay, push it in from the top. Okay. Come on. This thing go where it needs to go now. This just needs to sit. Yay. Okay. Now that'll stay in there without any problems. Good. So just leave that right there for now. Oh wait, what? This goes on. Oh, this goes on here. Okay, so this must be. Oops. Okay. Okay, so that's the orientation there. Oh, so the legs go into there. Well, we'll find out eventually. So, a couple of skirts that need to go on here. There we go. Now, out. The right way, and that's just going to keep on coming up. Okay. Well, let me get the other skirt on first. Oh, come on. These things aren't going on. Okay.
doesn't go on.
Okay, I had to step away for a second because I was having trouble getting these to fit in. I was expecting what would happen on the other kits I've worked on, where I would hear the ball joint snap into place, telling me that it was secure, and also noticing that it's very loose. So I did a little bit of research, and it turns out that for this kit, the very loose and not snapping in of the skirt pieces is very common and is kind of a known issue with this kit. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put the skirting pieces aside for right now. I will attach those at the very end. Otherwise, I'm going to be constantly having to put them back on because they're going to fall off as I'm building everything else. So I'm just going to skip that part of attaching them for right now and move on. Okay. There. This right there. Okay, need another little hook piece right here, but that might have gotten into a different bin, so I'll just, I know where it goes when I find it. This thing goes. This. Okay, yes, that is right. So that just kind of sits there. Okay, this holds it on better. Okay. And now that's more secure. Okay. Okay, so that here. Oops, I'm going to turn those around, okay. And then these clip on. Oops. And I have to probably pull those as well. These are awfully loose. This is the piece that goes here. once I find that extra hook, I'll be able to put that in. Okay, and I attached the legs. This is really loose. Okay. I expect that this will look good in the end. But by gosh, this is an incredibly loose kit. Like I said, this is the first iteration of the inner frame jointing and all that kind of stuff. I'll hold those off until the end as well. I think that they'd be a bit more... I guess that provides some hip action, but... Man. At least the knee joints are tight. Okay. Alright, body is next. Okay. Now it looks like the body also incorporates the backpack. They're all just one big combined piece. Whereas opposed with other kits, the backpack is separate. So let's see here. Do we turn anything? Doesn't look like it. let's just go on there for right now. Imagine those other pieces to secure it better. That's the front. That's where. Where's the front one? It's right here. This. I see. Okay, no, this is the front. Let's go on. This piece. There, okay, so this whole helps hold on the shoulders. So there's the front piece. And this is the back piece. Blue. There we go. Okay, now the shoulders are on there. Little blue pieces here. I'm supposed to just fit in. There we go. Yep. And very nice. Once again, some beautiful color separation there. We need our vents here that I painted. Instead of using the stickers for the gold on the louvers. Those just fit right there. This one right there. And then this piece binds everything together. That's good. Beautiful thing about these is since they're being put in behind pieces, I didn't have to worry about cleaning up or being too careful. I could just paint everywhere I wanted. Okay, so we've got the typical yellow neck or collar here. And then we've got a black detail that goes into here. here. Snap right down, no problem. And then, okay, this. And the red piece is here, so the tab points up. Whoops. Be careful. These have nothing securing them. And this just attaches right on up and in. Yes, this is definitely going to look very nice, just not something, once it's built, that you want to do anything with. There we go. This, I would call it a little pearl neck piece. I guess just basically the neck. And then you need to put this goes in here. Which way? That tab is up. Oh, that's cool. And then that opens up. That can, huh. Okay. Opens up a little bit at least. This suit. Those are those. Oh, these two snap together. That's what it is. This is interesting. It just shows you the two pieces next to each other. They don't actually show them going together. So it looked like it was one piece. That doesn't normally happen on these instructions, but I guess there was so much to do. Certain things got missed in the instructions. So, like I was saying, this is the very first Real Grade. So I'm going to give them some slack on this one. Because it's always hard to do something brand new. And hopefully they've learned with future ones. I mean, this is from... What year was this done? 2010, so this is a 13-year-old model. Is going here to the left. And once again, these don't really snap in, do they? Okay, well, more pieces to decide how to deal with as I build the rest of it. And this just kind of snapped right out, huh? Okay. Well, this is just in time because this is going to require those to be on there when I put the rest of the outside piece on. So, I'm going to have to do some gluing. Just means that these won't be able to move around once they're on there, but that's okay. So, just applying the glue to the ball joint part of it. Because I don't want to get glue everywhere. I'll just have it kind of point slightly down, but square. Okay, there's that one. What I'm using is the Mr. Hobby, Mr. Cement Deluxe. It's a thicker glue. I'm not using the thin or the light glue. I'm just using some regular good old model glue. Because that way these pieces will just stay in place. It does tend to dry fairly quickly, but I'm just going to give it some time. And you know what? I might as well do these at the same time. Once again, not ideal, but not really, considering where they are, the end of the world or anything like that. So what I'm going to actually do is take this off. Ah, wait a minute. I may not have the glue these. I had the thing in the wrong, in the reverse order. Because this has to be up, not the other part. Okay, yes, that is much, much nicer. There we go. Look at that. Okay, hey. Much better. Good. Don't have to glue those. There we go. Make sure the torso fits right on there. Okay. Cool. I'm going to do the head. Skip ahead and just do the head. Just so I can get... give that enough time to dry. And then the last part will be the arms. Lots of little teeny pieces again. Okay. Now this is going to require the eyes. So for the eyes, this yellow piece here. The eyes go right there. And as I said earlier, this is the only one from this sticker pack be using, because I have water slides for everything else. Get some better tweezers here. There we go. Is easier than most eyes I've done. This has a little nose ridge to guide it. Very nice. And these will be set back, so you're not going to see any of the lines or anything like that that the stickers normally cause. Even though these are realistic stickers and they're supposed to be thinner and show less edging and all that, there's still going to be the edging there. That's why I get the water slides instead. So, this right here. What's that? I think that's the one. Up. I figured the plastic piece would go over the eyes, and it doesn't. The eyes go on the plastic piece, and the plastic piece goes on. And of course, when I was talking plastic piece, I mean this clear plastic piece here. Should have realized when it was so easy to put this on, I might have been missing a step.
little bit more to hold on to. Come on.
Okay, I'll use the alternative here. It's the eye part is slightly raised. Stick this on here. The individual eyes. I guess these would be more lenses. It does turn out that the camera system does go through the lenses or the eyes. Or at least some of the. This is why I've never used the three-piece size. But I ruined the other ones, so this is why I had to do it. So, let's get this into... Okay. Okay. Well, okay. Let's just say forget that. And I will. This is the same gold that I use for the correcting part of it. Okay. So let that dry a little bit. Might as well put this on now because the glue should be at least dry enough as long as I don't do much to that. And then these go on to these little pegs right here. Okay. Just the right way. And then put that on. Okay. Okay. And this. Right here. And the side vents. Definitely is beautiful. And then this goes right up on top. Yeah. Very nice. Got the yellow Vulcan cannons pointing out. Very nice. Nice. go. Let's stick him over there. And then this snaps on to nice. So that's the front. This is the back one. There's there. There we go. Now make sure to get these little fins in the back. And then this. Right there. And then this clips on top to hold everything in. There we go. That's a nice little head. Again, right there. Just a simple ball joint. That's the only movement is the ball joint. Okay. Okay. I'll go back and do the arms. So, excuse me. So, we've got this, and it came already attached with this, on the small side here. Eventually tell you to take off. Let's snap down. Okay, cool. Another piece that comes out. Okay. This and that. We'll figure that out. Side opposite. And that goes like that. This little guy. And here. Counterpart. little nub that tells you which one goes in which. It fits into there, so you can't put them on the wrong side, which is nice. Okay. This. This piece? Yep. It's got a little T that fits in this T here. That must be the elbow armor. Yep. It's actually. It is the elbow.
quite figure out what it's trying to tell me. This little piece is talking about. Now that makes sense. As to how that's supposed to go in. This comes on. Doesn't quite fit together, is that the whole idea here? That's the whole idea. Obviously, it'd be some type of separation effect that happens there. And the elbow bends. Okay.
much nicer. Okay. This. Seems quite loose as well. That's kind of just okay. And then the wrist collar goes on. Oh, this one here. They had them on both sides within gray matter. That makes that a bit tighter. Has to be this way. There we go. Thank you. nicely right there. But then... just a huge gap. That can't be right. Design to hold that in place, okay. That's all that does, is that just holds. Okay. Okay. Oh, shoulder to put together still, right? This model requires a lot of patience. Oh boy. You have got to be kidding me. That just sits like that. Well, I guess when they decided to go the real grade, they wanted to go realistic. And I guess that makes sense, because obviously in the real world, this was built by the lowest bidder. Wow. There's got to be something amiss, isn't there? Let's just put the second arm together. I know, I bet this was just enough piece, something that held pieces together. On the runner. It's probably not anything that goes on here. Let's do, put this back on here just to keep it all together. Now arm number two. That grips down. Okay, left arm. The elbow. Shoulder. Okay. There's the knee. It's there.
should get glued on, I'm assuming. This one here.
Okay. Okay. Oh. This is coming off all over the place. Let's just go down here. Okay. And there's him. Oops, if I put it down the right way. Right. Didn't put this on the right way the second time, did I? There we go. There we go. Yes. That is correct. Toes are in the front. It's a huge freaking gap. That doesn't look... Oh, because the skirts aren't on there, because the skirts were blocked. Okay. Skirts hide that huge gap. There we go. That looks nice. Some piece on the leg here. Okay. Pieces I missed on the runner. see. The lake top. D5, D15, let's see. Ah, I did. Good. Yep, and there's the other clip that I missed. Might as well take off the little Amuro figure as well. There's no pilot figure for this, it's just a standing Amuro. Probably couldn't have gotten enough detail in the with a 1/44th scale sitting a pilot. Because actually, if you, with the master grade ones, and there for right now because he's not going anywhere. But for the master grade ones, they will give you a proper 1/100th scale standing figure. But the seated pilot figure is always smaller and has always appeared to me to be a 1/144th scale. So if they had to do a 1/144th scale for the master grade, you can imagine how small it would have to be for the real grade or high grade, though. I bet you would just basically be a blob of plastic, because actually, even in some high grades where they do provide, or they do have a seated pilot, it's molded into the chest unit, or the head unit, depending upon where the pilot is, like if it's the gun tank, that had the pilot right in the head unit molded already. Just feeling for rough spots to see. So when I take things off the runners, I use my God hand, single blade. And those are, it's great. I can pretty much just take the piece off as one piece. You know, the nub right off it, right from the beginning. Right way. There we go. That looks much, much better. Okay. There we go. There's that. And then this little guy here. Definitely want to get the nub off this because it's going to fit in a very tight area. So, look at the waist. Go, and that's where custom attachment goes for the display stand. Doesn't use a standard one. I've already taken the custom one off the runner. Okay, so starting to understand why the term hand grenade was coined for certain models. You can imagine how, I don't know. I mean, if this being the first real grade, and it was this way, it makes me wonder how that line survived. They must have made changes almost immediately with newer kits. I know actually the second one, I believe, is the Char Zaku 2, and I think that already had an upgraded inner frame. I think it was the version 2. Oops. Oh my god! One under the table, I'll get it later. Okay. I mean, it does look really nice. I do like the way it looks. There's a couple gaps, places where, you know, but I guess it's not as, well, a bit noticeable at places, but. Oh, you know what? I bet you that's where shield attaches or something. I bet that's why there's a gap there. I bet you that's where things attach into. Because I don't see any other type of, peg receptacle. But I mean, it does look really nice. I'm really impressed with the amount of detail they could get on such a small model. I mean, it is hefty. It just is very loose in places. And you know, I guess it is the first time they did this, so I guess I gotta cut them a little bit of slack based on that, but Wow, this has just been an exercise in not necessarily frustration, but challenge. An exercise in challenge mitigation. Let me get the weapons together here. Just leave him in there. Okay. Beam rifle first, so. This looks into put this on first. There we go. Okay, so that's that. That we move. This is where the sighting goes. Typical yellow dish on it. Okay. And that. Put this on before I put anything else on. This is the peg that'll attach it various places. It fits into the handle. Here we go. Move the body here. That is G. Well, let me put the bazooka together first, then.
fault.
This is... Yeah, that's not as tight, so that's good. Okay, get those lined up as much as I can. Oh, I see. Okay. And it goes, there we go. See that. It's a little bit too far, does it? That's the clip to attach it to there. This is the special attachment for the on the base. And for the shield, and doing the torso, actually no, in doing the arms, I believe, there was a certain piece he had to take off. And those will be used for the shield grasping mechanism. That's cool. She slides back and forth. Okay. Yep, that's what, okay, yep. There's why there's those gaps. That right there will fit in the gaps for the arms. Whoop. Let's see here. There we go. Right there. That's the attachment. Right there for the arm, the shield on the arm. Whoops. Okay. Okay. Now, these can be taken off the backpack and actually stored right inside the shield here instead. There's a little slot here that these fit right in. They both fit right there next to each other. Which is cool. And then there are separate ones here for the actual grasping hands. These here have a little slot in them, which these fit into. Put there, and then you can close a hand around it to hold it, just like that. And then that goes in the arm, that goes in the wrist to replace it, so you can actually, if you store these in the shield, you don't have to worry about taking them off the backpack when you have these in fighting mode, and it's got the two beams right here. Just fit into the whole light standard. And of course these will fit into these as well, but these aren't able to be grasped as easily in the hand. Of Cool.
This is one of the pieces that they pulled off. It is. I guess those aren't used.
Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please do give it a thumbs up. That really does help out the channel. And if you would like to see more like this, please go ahead and subscribe and click the notification bell. If you do have some time, I would really appreciate it if you could watch one of the videos that are popping up around my head.